Artificial tears are generally the first thing patients with dry eye reach for. In my dry eye clinic, artificial tears have usually been tried before coming in, but do they even help? In today's video, I'll go over artificial tears and whether or not they're helping your dry eyes. Welcome back to Eye School with me, Dr. D, where I teach you about products and treatments related to dry eye syndrome and eye beauty so that you can have healthy, beautiful, comfortable eyes. Give a little love tap on that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the latest eye tips and tricks I have for you. When you're treating dry eyes, it's important to use a combination of different therapies in order to improve quality of life and symptoms and generally improve your patient's condition. While I have newer interventional treatments that I tend to favor over the older treatments like artificial tears, it's still important to recognize the situation in which artificial tears can really help a patient. So in this video, I'll talk about how artificial tears can be helpful and the ways in which they definitely are not. Before we get started, make sure to check out drmelaniedenton.com and download my free dry eye routine tracker. I created this tracker to help you keep up with your day-to-day dry eye treatments so you can start to know which ones are working and which ones aren't. I also have a tracker to help you bring to your dry eye specialist with all the treatments you've tried in the past. This is something that as a dry eye specialist, I feel like would be very helpful to me. Basically just taking stock of the treatments you've done before. So if you find that helpful, great. Take that to your dry eye specialist and let me know down below if they appreciated that. So let's first talk about how artificial tears help. There is a quality of life benefit. The truth is, artificial tears just feel good. I've heard it said that putting in an artificial tear is kind of like using a breath mint. It feels really good on your eyes, it makes them feel wonderful, but after about 10 minutes or so, that dryness and irritation is going to come back. Now, in a breath mint, they're going to make your breath really fresh and nice. But again, after about 10 minutes, your stinky breath is going to be right back where it was. And that's just how it is with artificial tears. They'll make those dry, irritated eyes feel better for a short period. But once they wear off, the dryness and irritation is back. However, there's no denying that using artificial tears can be very helpful for situational tasks, like being on a computer for a long period. We all know that throwing in an artificial tear can be just what you need to revitalize those tears and make your eyes feel more comfortable and your vision better. Next, let's discuss optical quality. It's no secret that it's critical to have a healthy tear film in order to see well. For instance, in clinic, when patients are being refracted in my chair, so that just means that they're getting their glasses prescription checked, some patients will note that their vision is fluctuating, or I'll notice that their answers seem to be changing and their vision is fluctuating actively while we're working on their prescription. One thing I do as a pro tip is I put in an artificial teardrop, and when you find that that helps a patient's vision, it's very clear that, okay, we have an ocular surface issue. So if you've ever had this, one option might seem clear and then the alternate seems clear, and if you blink, it seems to clear. This clinically is one of the most obvious signs that my patients are suffering from a fluctuating tear film. And if you experience vision that fluctuates like I just described, then artificial tears may be very helpful in order to give you that nice tear film and that clear refracting surface that's going to make your vision and your optical quality more consistent. Okay, I'm stumbling on my words, but if you've made it this far and you're still awake, please hit that thumbs up down below so YouTube knows that this is good quality content. Now let's get into what artificial tears can't do. Artificial tears, although helpful in many circumstances, cannot do it all. Notably, they're unable to help with ocular inflammation, reducing meibomian gland obstruction, or killing demodex mites. In terms of decreasing ocular surface inflammation, ocular surface inflammation is present in virtually every type of dry eye disease from every cause of dry eye. That's the definition of dry eye, is chronic low-grade inflammation of the ocular surface. So artificial tears are unable to help with ocular surface inflammation. Furthermore, by altering the tear chemistry and artificially putting in more aqueous into the tear film, it's possible that they could worsen your dry eye inflammation. In order to treat ocular inflammation from dry eye disease, doctors use a combination of anti-inflammatories like steroids, as well as immunomodulators like cyclosporine and lifitegrast. The second thing artificial tears cannot do is they cannot decrease your obstruction. 86% of dry eye disease has a meibomian gland dysfunction component. Therefore, reducing gland obstruction, reducing that meibomian gland dysfunction is absolutely critical in treating dry eye long term. Unfortunately, artificial tears do absolutely nothing to clear gland obstruction. The only treatments we have that help with gland obstruction include utilizing heat on the eyelids paired with expression to clear the glands. And currently, there are no artificial tears that are going to impact the glands in this way. And therefore, artificial tears are pretty much useless when it comes to meibomian gland dysfunction. And finally, killing Demodex mites. Artificial tears are just ineffective at killing Demodex mites on the eyelid. Demodex mite infestation is quite common, especially as we get older, and results in changes in meibomian gland secretions, eyelid irritation, and the symptoms of dry eye disease. Treating Demodex usually requires several strategies, but things like tea tree oil, intense pulse light have been proven effective in killing Demodex mites and reducing their overpopulation on the lids. Unfortunately, again, this is just an area where artificial tears are not helping anything. Undoubtedly, artificial tears will be a piece of your dry eye treatment regimen, and that is completely normal and I support it. I recommend artificial tears for nearly all of my patients. However, it's important to understand what they're good at and what they're not good at so that you can have reasonable expectations of where they fit in your daily dry eye routine. Remember that they can be wonderful for making your eyes feel better as well as see better in a very short-term setting. However, you must consider how you're going to get your inflammation under control, how you're going to clear gland obstruction, and how you're going to deal with the overpopulation of Demodex mites if that's an issue for you. Make sure to let me know down below your experience with artificial tears. Tell me your favorites, ones you can't stand, and those that you'd just love to try. And if you've made it this far and you're not already subscribed to my channel, please hit that button down below so you don't miss any notifications. That's going to be it for today's iSchool. Class is dismissed.